Today's topic is the reality of seed investment mathematics, and it's actually based on some of my experiences of being a venture capitalist. But one of the quick things that you'll learn is that the more investments you make, the higher the likelihood of having at least one success. But this can also be applied to products, any type of a product. So the more products you put out, the higher the likelihood of having one become a super hit. Books, you know, the more books you write, you know, for instance, I'm on my fourth book right now. And the more books you write, the higher the likelihood of it having one become a super hit. Same thing with films, so the more films you produce. Obviously, any type of effort, so if you're focused on a specific effort, the more frequently you make them, the higher the likelihood of the success. And there's a lot of reasons for it. One of them, I think, is the experience curve. But the biggest reason, in my opinion, is the mathematics behind it. And so let's go through this because I found this very fascinating because it is applicable from statistics. If you look at the formula of 1%, 1 minus percent likelihood of failing, of all startups failing. So let's say that you are investing into X amount of startups and you want to find out what is your likelihood of one becoming a successful super hit. And this is how actually the venture capitalists operate. Most of the venture capitalists understand that, you know, you're playing the numbers game, so you have to be able to invest into at least 10 startups to get a super hit, so you hope. But bottom line is that if you look at this formula, 1 minus percent likelihood of all failing to the power of number of investments, what you can do is you can play with the numbers a little bit, and I did a little bit of it for us. So the assumption is that each investment has a 10% likelihood of success. So for instance, if you invested into one startup, okay, your likelihood of success based on just the simple assumption of 10% is 10%. And if you look at the restaurant industry, I mean, if you're opening up at a restaurant, for example, your likelihood of a success is probably 10%. Okay, I don't think it applies to every type of a sector, but, and also this assumption is going to vary depending on the experience of the entrepreneur, depending on the type of funding available and so on, and their ability to raise capital and create great products, all kinds of variables. But you can still play with the statistics to understand the seed mathematics involved and how important numbers are. If you do two startups, okay, if you fund two startups, two products, two films, you know, then your likelihood of success of at least one of them being successful ends up being 19% because you're just plugging in this formula, okay? 1 minus percent likelihood of all failing to the number of investments. And then if you go to 5 startups, okay, now your chances of having at least one successful startup is 40%, 40.9%. Of course, if you invest into 10 startups, your chances substantially increase. And as you can tell, by the time you invested into 20 startups, you're gonna have one of them, at least one of them become successful. And this is where the seed mathematics do come into play. But let's do the one together right now. So if let's say you invested into 30, okay? So I'm gonna get my formula out. So I'm gonna put in 0.9 to the power of 30 investments, whatever they are, whether they're startups or products or films. Okay, and then I'm gonna subtract that from 1 minus that. And so now the likelihood, okay, of having at least one startup become a success is 95.7%. This is all based on statistics. I'm not making this up. I mean, you don't even have to be an experienced investor or an entrepreneur that's launched a lot of products. The math does work for you. So what you have to realize is that the more investments you make, whether it's into products, into films, into making, publishing books, any type of ideas, the more of them you make, the higher the likelihood of having at least one successful one. Now, if you can change this formula, okay, from 10%, okay, to a higher number, then let's do some math for a second. In fact, I will do that. Let's do 10 for a second. So now it's not 9.9, it's 0.8, okay? and I'm going to do 10 startups, and now I'm going to subtract it. So now at 20%, okay, so now your assumption each investment has a 20% likelihood of success, okay? And I did this example right here, okay, 10 startups. So now what it comes down to that instead of 65.1% likelihood that I'm gonna have at least one startup successful, it goes up to 89.2%, okay? And this is how the numbers work. So now your key question is, how do I change the assumption of percent likelihood of all failing or percent likelihood of one of them succeeding, okay? So now you have to account for if you build a better management team, okay, for one. If you really have done enough due diligence on the idea before you spend a lot of money doing it. But once again, the math will always work in your favor. And then you have to define what is success. For instance, maybe I'm being a little harsh because I have a venture capital mentality, but to me, a super success is if you create a company that ends up going public or is acquired for $1 billion. Now, as an entrepreneur, it's all relative, you know? So if you're building a company and you consider success to be $100 million exit, which ironically, there's statistics involved in most, 95% of all startups are acquired for $100 million or less. And so if you take that assumption of building a startup from zero and being sold as for $100 million as an example, well, that's your success definition. And there's nothing wrong with that. So bottom line is it's all relative. The mathematics always come into play. And now what you have to always think about is how do I increase per startup my likelihood of at least one of my efforts becoming more successful? And that is where the magic formula plays out. If you do it just quickly, one more, I know this is math oriented here, but if you quickly do it where you change it at 30% instead of 20, so now I'm gonna do let's just say 0.7, and I'm gonna raise it to the power of 5, and now for just 5 startups, okay, and I'm going to now subtract it. So now, if I change this, okay, if I change all this to 5, but now it's 7, okay, and it was before at 10% was 40%, okay, now I've increased my chances of 83.2% likelihood that at least one of the 5 is going to startups is going to become a success. And as you can tell, you can play with these numbers, but once again, you have to think about it. And this is why this statistics formula does work, because you have to play the numbers game. So be very cognizant of that, whether you're an entrepreneur, product manager, or an angel investor or venture capitalist. Until next time.